In this video, we're gonna learn the famous, very famous queuing model. We call this M1Q. And the first M, according to the textbook, refers to the arrival process having a Markovian property, which means inter-arrival time is exponential distributed. And the second M refer to the departure time is exponentially distributed, or this departure process is a Markovian. This departure time can also be interpreted as a service time. It means some customer enters the queue and got service and get out. And also, I wanna remark that this MM1Q follows what's called a FIFO rule. This is a first in, first out. It means no job can cut in the line, and we'll see that this plays a lot important roles in the. If you guys learn a computer network or a network service, so how server allocates resources or how your computer system allocates resources, this plays an important role. And let's learn basically this setup. First, we have a single server. And we have the arrival, which is of a constant rate. Lambda, okay. And then we have also after a customer arrived at this service, if the server is free, then he basically enters the service. If there is a customer in the service, he has to wait, which puts him in the queue. And the service time is of a constant rate as well, and this constant rate is mu. Okay. And apparently, this lambda is our lambda n in previous video, and this mu is our mu n in previous video. So lambda and mu, they don't depend on the number of customers in the this queue. Okay, and by the way, I'm saying customer, but this MM1Q is has more application actually in computer system. You guys can view this service as your computer, and this arrival is like the tasks, or say some tasks assigned by the program. And now, so for example, in our XT, basically represents the total number of customer in the system. So for example, if xt is 2, it means at time t, there is 1 in service, so 1 is being served, and there is another 1 in the queue. And apparently, we can think about the transition probabilities. So it's transition probabilities for the underlying discrete Markov chain. So apparently, P01, like we said last time, this is of course 1. This is simply given after the nth transition, where s stays 0, there is no in 1, then the next transition must be the total number of customers in the system becomes 1. And then similarly, we can have let me use this p here, the pn to n plus 1 is simply lambda divided by lambda plus mu, and pn to n minus 1 is mu divided by lambda plus mu. Okay, this is just plug in the formula we derived in previous video. Okay, I mean, this one is nothing fancy, but now we move on to the next one, which is what happens if we have a multi-server system. Okay, and for simplicity, let's just consider this MM2. We still follow the first in, first out rule, but this time we have two servers. And of course, x of t still is a number of customers in the system. And but now, because we have two servers, for example, what if xt is 4? It simply means because we have two servers, we must have 2 in service, okay? And we have another 2 in the queue. Now, let's consider the ti, which is or tn, which is from state n, and we leave state n, okay? And now what happens is if, but this time because we have two servers, something will be different. And think about when x of t is 0 or 1, okay? This means we have 0 in the system or 1 in the system. Then this is as if, okay, there is a, like, because if there is a 1, 0, or 1 customer, or say individual in the system, basically the second server is like idle before the next change. And what I want to say is the holding time actually is the same with the one for MM1 model. It's basically V0 is lambda, and the V1 is lambda plus mu. Okay? It's simply because if we have a server 1 and if we have server 2, if currently there is a, for example, 1 here, and then if next individual comes in, it sees an idle server, it will go to S2. And this is actually the same with MM1, because we actually don't like take advantage of this multi-server. The multi-server only, not only, but the difference when there are 2 or more customer in the system. So when xt is, let's say this is I, is greater than 2, then if a new customer comes into the line, he has to wait, okay? And let's assume SR1 to be the remaining service time of S1, and similarly S sub R2 is remaining service time of server number 2. Okay, and because keep this in mind, they are independent, first of all, and also they are memoryless, which follows the exponential distribution. As a result, we know that the time before our next departure is then, because we have two server in service, now whichever finishes first, it's gonna admit another customer, which means there is another departure. So this means the time until next departure is just at the minimum at this two. And earlier in a previous video, we derived that the minimum of two exponentially distributed random variables is just we sum up their rate. As a result, this is exponential distribution of mu plus mu. So we assume the service time, they follow the same distribution and they are independent. Moreover, we know that the time until next arrival, okay. And by the way, the arrival process is unchanged. It's just now we have more service. This is given by exponential distribution of lambda. Okay, and by the way, the arrival and departure are independent, and now we have derived then the time until next change for xt equals I that's greater than or equal to 2 is then an exponential distributed random variable with lambda plus 2 mu. Okay. And we can simply follow this. What we can have is we can derive the following, that is from I to I plus 1 there is a possibility of lambda divided by lambda plus 2 mu. Okay, and from I to I minus 1 this equals basically 2 mu divided by lambda plus 2 mu, and this is for I is greater than or equal to 2. And for I is less than or equal to 1, the case is the same as mm of 1.